Check this out. Just got out of the post office, and there's only like, I think there's only like 10 cars in the lot right now. It's crazy. It's like December 22nd. There's actually like more people behind the counter than there was in line. I don't think I've ever seen that. All the days of all sinners. Here, get back there. Yeah, I was just like amazed. I figured this was probably going to be the worst day of the worst, you know, because yesterday was pretty bad.
Hey everybody, it's Jeff Lafferty, ArtCast number 287. Getting up there towards 300. So I gotta right off the bat apologize for this video. I'm not doing my usual drawing and talking. I'm actually recording a voiceover because I didn't realize my camera has a setting to record just video and not audio. So I recorded the whole show without any audio and didn't realize it. So that was kind of a drag, but it's okay. I actually got a question in an email from a guy named Scott. Not Scott Circlin, you know, the guy I do the weekly ArtCast with. This was a different Scott. I guess he had went back and listened to my blogs, my early blogs, and wanted to know how hard it was to start my business online, you know, back when, well, maybe I should just go ahead and tell the story. What is it? It's almost been, I guess it's getting close to 2 years now. I think I'm about 4 months away. But 2 years ago, I left my job. I was working for a house painting company and just really unsatisfied with everything and pissed off. And one day I just walked out the door and did not go back and came home and started drawing. I just was like, you know, I'm not going to do this anymore. I'm going to do something else. And I went home. I had Boba Fett, like, commission, I think, that was like half done. I had couple other pieces that people had bought and kind of gave me half the money for, and I hadn't got done, and I was just like, I'm just going to stay home and I'm going to just draw these commissions, and I'm going to put the word out, I'm going to put stuff on eBay, and I'm going to see if I can make this work. And, you know, here it is, you know, whatever, year and a half over that, and I'm still doing it. And so I guess that's what Scott means, is he's just wondering, like, how tough was it to get started in the beginning. And, yeah, it was hard, but it wasn't impossible. I actually should, like, preface this also, because I've heard other people on other podcasts kind of mention me. The way they kind of phrased it is, well, he already worked as an artist before this, so it's kind of like no big deal that I did it again or something like that. And that is true. I worked a long time ago, back in the 90s, in comics for, like, I don't know, 5 or 6 years. And then again, I don't know what this would have been, 2005, 6, somewhere around there, I worked for a few years just drawing sketch cards and staying home. And I also sold some nudes at that time too. So it is true. It wasn't as scary this time around as it was, like, say, when I jumped out from sketch cards. But I will say one thing, though. Beyond maybe giving you a slight bit of confidence that you can actually get somewhere with your heart, with your art, it's like, you know, having done comics, you know, at one time in your life really doesn't, you know, doesn't get you anything. If you're stuck in a dead-end job, you know, that's not getting you out of it. I'm still just a guy that, you know, can draw and decided that I didn't want to work for somebody. But, you know, there you go, full disclosure, that's what I've done, and you can, you know, take it however you want it. So let's see, let me think, going back, I guess this kind of his question was about how hard it was, and I think the hardest part was walking out the door, because once you kind of start accepting that check from somebody again, it's so hard to think, okay, I'm not going to get that check at the end of the week. And of course, you know, when you're working a job, or like at least when I work, I never made like tons of money. I was pretty much check to check. So, you know, the thought of like not taking that check, and especially when you have a son and a wife and people counting on you, you don't want to screw things up too bad. You know what I mean? You don't want to take like the critical risk that could take you guys down for good. And so like that was probably the scariest part. When I did it this last time, it was kind of almost, I feel like a kind of fate, you know. I believe in God and all that, and I'm always assigning, you know, importance to things that may or may not be, you know, important, I guess. But my dad got sick at the time, and he, like, passed out at the sale he was at. He was, like, at a livestock sale and fell down and went to the hospital. And so I left work to go see if he was okay. And so I even though I was angry and was having a hard time at work, like getting along with some people and stuff, I didn't leave and, like, you know, I didn't, like, throw down my my tools and go, like, you know, take this job and shove it. I actually went to see if he was okay. And then by the time I got there, he was okay. He had come home and he was fine. He just had, like, a cold, and it had, I think it was just super wore out. So, like, over the next, you know, few days, I kind of, like, took him out some food and stuff and just kind of checked on him, and he was okay. So, but I was home, you know, I was like home for a day, like during the week. Like, I remember coming home that day and being like, should I go back to work? And just sort of thinking like, I have this commission sitting here on the desk, you know what I mean? I may as well finish this up before I go back. And then it was like the next day, I thought, well, you know, if I draw another thing, I could put it on eBay and not go back today. And it was kind of this like stair step thing. So I kind of had this out that I don't know. I kind of think it probably would have happened anyway. I probably would have got to the point where I did just leave out of anger or something. But I didn't have to. It was kind of a coincidence thing. And then I just didn't go back, you know. And then like a week later, you know, I tell my wife, and, you know, if you go back and watch the first videos, that's what the whole video is about, is the fact that I'm not at work and I haven't told my wife yet that I'm going to quit. So anyway, once I was out the door, was it tough? I mean, in the beginning, yeah, it's spooky, but it's like you're working, you know, out of fear, so you're just drawing like crazy. And I know for the first, you know, like 5 months that I was at home, I was just working like, you know, 14-hour days. I mean, it was hard, but it wasn't like overly terrifying, because I was working so fast and so hard that I was staying ahead. I don't know if Scott's like talking about trying to do this himself or something, but that is something to remember, is like, you know, once you get your back up against the wall, it's a lot different than when you're drawing at night and you're trying to stay up and do something and then go to work tomorrow. You know, like once you're home, it's like you've got no excuse not to work. And you know, the only, I want to say like the only, you know, reason you're going to fail is if you let yourself fail. But that's not entirely true, because it's, you know, you've got to, there's more to it than just that. You know, you've got to have like a place where the money's going to come from. But once you have that, once you kind of like have a pretty good idea of like, if I do this, then I'm going to get paid for that, then it's just opened up, you know. Then it's just, you just, you know, how hard can you work, basically. But like one of the things that made it easier in the beginning was the fact that I had a market, which my market was like eBay and also commissions. I still had some clients that were, you know, from back from the sketch card days that were still buying stuff from me. So those guys were out there, and they were just an email away, you know. Not all of them, you know, came back, but a few of them did, and that helped. And also, you know, I just started hitting eBay, like, super hard, and that had worked for me in the past, and it started to work again. Because, like, online, you know, especially with art, you see a lot of, to me, it's like the two sides of it, where you have one side is, like, the physical product side, which is like you have something to sell, which to me is like original art. That's my main one, right? But then you also have people that are like the webcomic side of things, where it's sort of like I'm going to build up this audience that looks at my webcomics, that kind of falls in love with me, and then, you know, once a year I'm going to hit them with like a Kickstarter and they're going to buy that book, or there's just going to be so many people that, like, you know, love my stuff and hit my site, that AdSense or affiliate links can support me. And I think that the second part, you know, the second version of that, like the webcomics version, or I don't even want to say it's a webcomics version, it's just like the, what would that be? I mean, is that crowdfunding? Like, I mean, Kickstarter, of course, is crowdfunding, but like when you're building the audience, you know, it's like the 1,000 true fans thing. I think that's always the harder way to go, because like when you can actually make a product and sell it, you can do, I mean, you only need that one guy that's going to buy it. The, you know what I mean? You can actually make it work with like a way smaller audience than you can, like, on the other side of it, where it's like you have to have this massive audience and they all kind of just give you a little bit. Obviously, it works both ways. Like, you know, Jason Brubaker and other webcomics guys, you know, make it work that way, and, you know, guys like me make it work this way, right? Let's see, what else? But the physical products, like with me, that was the base. You know what I mean? It was just like, draw a piece, sell a piece, draw a piece, sell a piece. It was just like, just do it again and again. You know, in the beginning especially, that was my focus, which was just, how much art can I get out? You know, then you're able to like expand on that, so that you're not quite so like just chasing the next sale constantly, because you can bring in prints, you can bring in like basically passive income. You know, like prints is, it's not completely passive, but it, you know, as you do prints and you sell prints, it's like you don't have to draw that print, you just, you know, it's basically you're just shipping it, right? And then books is the same thing, even though I haven't got into books yet. And then, you know, there's other things. There's other things like Patreon also. And Patreon helps. It still helps me today. Also, just, affiliate links. I mean, I've talked about this a few times. Nobody ever listens. But just having, you know, that affiliate relationship with eBay, where you make money from the traffic you send to eBay. But that's stuff that you build as you go, or even like the YouTube money, like the YouTube ads, AdSense on my YouTube videos, it's the same thing. It's not a ton, but it's a little bit. All these things kind of come together and help you make money. But, you know, I would have to say like the passive part of my business compared to like the active part, which is just drawing and selling the next piece, it's a lot smaller, a ton smaller, but every little bit helps. And every bit of that has the potential to grow too. Is there stuff that, I mean, like the big thing about, you know, starting a business like that where you're like getting a paycheck 1 week and then stepping out the next week and you have no savings, because that was another thing. I had no savings when I started this. When I walked out the door, I mean, I maybe had $300 in the bank. It was, you know, it wasn't the ideal situation. So if anything, I would say that probably hurt me, was just like starting from ground zero, even though like it might have helped me also, like thinking back on it, because just that fear, or, you know, just because, you know, it's like trying to swim from a shark or something. You're going to swim faster than you probably ever swam, you know. So like, you know, just having my back up against the wall, it's like, you know, you're going to do everything in your power to keep going. So that might have been a plus. I was going to say that hurt me, but that actually might have been a plus. So I don't know. I don't really know what would be the hurt me ones. I mean, there's just the overall thing of just, you know, it not being the ideal situation. And, you know, should somebody else do it? I don't, you know, I can't even answer that really, because everybody's got to weigh their options, you know. It's way scary. I know there's a ton of people that think about it. I think that, like, that's a ton of my audience. You know, I think that really is, like, the people that come and listen to my shows. Or maybe the core section of people. Even the people that have, like, really good jobs and they just do art on the side. And I think, you know, in the back of their minds even, they probably kind of think about, you know, well, could I do it? Maybe. You know, maybe could I do it? And I think that's part of, like, the appeal of, like, my channel, is, you know, that I did it. I think if I was going to tell anybody, you know, like advice or whatever, just tell them something about the whole situation, what I would say would be like don't do it if you can't fail, you know. And by that I mean, like, don't do it unless you're ready to fail. Like, you're ready for things to get hard. Because, like, things are immediately going to get hard. And they can go from, like, you know, they can get really hard and it might not work. So, if you're the kind of guy who's not, like, willing to lose anything, and by that I mean, like, I don't know how do I put this? I mean, I'm not a guy who like lived way beyond my means, and I'm also not a guy that makes a ton of money. You should put out that too. I mean, you guys see where I live. I live in a freaking trailer, you know. My car's old and broken down. Well, it's not broken down, it's running, but it's old. And you know, I'm not, you know, living in palatial splendor, you know. But I am living like free, you know. It's like I make my own rules, and when I get up in the morning, I do what I feel is important, not what someone else thinks is important for me, and that's worth something. But back to what I was saying was, like, you know, if it would have came down, I mean, I didn't have a car to lose because I didn't have loans on my cars, but would I have been ready to lose a car? Yeah. Totally would have been worth that. Maybe even lose the house. And that was something that was a possibility. And in the back of my mind, I was kind of like, that's going to suck, but can we get through it? You know, because I do have relatives, you know. And I damn sure didn't want that to happen. I definitely didn't want to move in with somebody else. But it was a risk I was willing to take, you know. That was on the table, and it still is, you know. It still is. Things could make a bad turn at any point, right? So, but that's, you know, losing your house and going to live, you know, with, you know, your brother or something, is not, you know, losing one of your family members or something like that. You're not like crossing a river and maybe your wife's gonna get washed away or something. That's not a, you know, risk that's worth taking. But that, you know, the physical stuff, for me anyway, was worth it. I could definitely lose some physical stuff, you know. You know, that's just the way I look at life too. You know, like, what's important. And, you know, the most important thing to me is like my kids and my wife. And honestly, that's another reason that I left when I did, because I was I spend a lot of time working now, but it's like my son can come and say hi to me anytime he wants. I usually have lunch with him. I'm around when he gets up and has breakfast, you know. I'm not... I mean, sometimes when I would paint, I mean, in the summertime, we'd be like, we'd work a day and then, you know, work another job into the night, and I wouldn't even get home until he was in bed, and I wouldn't see him, you know. That's just unacceptable to me, you know. I mean, I don't know, it's just, that was a lot of it, though, was just the fact that I wanted to be, like, a bigger part of, you know, my kid's life and my wife's life. I wanted to be around as a dad, you know, and that was a big part of it, too, you know. It was like, because I was trying to be an artist, still holding on to the sort of the dream of being an artist, I spent so much time pursuing the art part of it after work. When I'd come home from, you know, work, I'd eat dinner and Tristan would go to bed. Then I would stay up till like 3 in the morning, and then I would get up the next day at whatever, 6:30 or something, and, you know, be dead fucking tired, and, you know, go to work, and I was just constantly like running myself to like those ragged edges. Which I know isn't healthy or anything, but it's just, you know, how else are you going to do it? That's like the only time you have is like after work. And like, you know, beyond that, like one more thing that I saw from all that kind of stuff, beyond the whole family thing, and that made me mad that I wasn't, you know, getting to see my family enough, was the fact that when I would work at night, I could see the potential of the business, and potentially I could make, you know, enough money to make a living at this whole thing. But I couldn't do it with that damn job in the way, because I couldn't get enough time in at the drawing table. Well, I hope this was a good show. It was kind of fun to kind of like look back and just think about, you know, all that kind of stuff now that it's kind of passed and I'm not in panic mode. At the time, like when I left work, you bet I thought about it, you know, 24/7, but anymore, you know, I don't think about it that much. I just try to get enough pieces drawn to, you know, stay afloat. But I would definitely say that, you know, to wrap it up, though, I mean, I already kind of said it, but, you know, I mean, life is like an adventure, you know, and even though you get old and, you know, you get beat down and your dreams get crushed and all that kind of stuff, it's still like the only shot you got, you know. It's like once you end up in the grave, this whole chance was over. And you can either take the shot and fail, and that's what I'd rather do. And I definitely improved it through my life, because I've always looked for the door, you know what I mean? I've never sort of like been able to quell the desire to be an artist or do creative things inside of me. And I've always had this like burning need or something to make it what I think about all day, you know? I didn't have time for other people's dreams. I wanted to like focus on my own, even if I was gonna fail, even if I was, you know, it was gonna cost me, you know, stuff. I hope that's motivational to people out there that are like me, I guess, you know. I don't want anybody to quit their job and lose their house and their cars and everything else, but if it's what they want, then I do want them to do it, you know. If it's what they want and they're just being cautious because they think that that's what they're supposed to do, then I think, yeah, you should go for it. So anyway, I hope this show helped whoever, you know, is listening out there. And I'll see you guys. I don't know if I'll make more shows this week or not. I might. I don't know. I was kind of thinking about doing the Daily Artcast again. I might not. I might. I don't know. I'm not sure what I'm thinking. So I'm just playing it by ear, trying to figure out like what I really have time for, what I really want to do, what I feel creatively motivated to do. But hit that like button. I don't care if you didn't like the video or not. Hit that like button. I appreciate it. Also, subscribe if you are not subscribed. And also, check me out on Patreon if you want to help me out. See you guys next time, whenever that's going to be, for another video. See ya.